Doggo and child wish you an awesome day. Pregnant women of Reddit, what is something you wish you knew before you got pregnant? You can order one, but get two. Username checks out. Don't get me started. Oh, dear. You can order one and get three. Don't make my one and done mistake. Edit, my kids aren't a mistake. The awesome internal parts deciding a multiple birth was better than three spaced out kids while three was the plan. Three babies at once, not so much. Baby kicks don't feel like butterflies. They feel like something crawled across your skin quickly, but from the inside. Yep. Always expected something to burst out like the scene from Alien. I mean, it kinda does at the end. Mine felt like gas. Didn't think anything of it for 2 weeks, since I was already pretty flatulent. Then they started feeling like sharp jabs and urges to pee. Mine is using my bladder as a punching bag. It's not the kicks, that other nightmare. It's when the baby gets bigger and it's more of a rolling motion underneath your skin. Gives me the heebie-jeebies. I also find the hiccups to be unsettling. Today I learned they can hiccup in the womb. Or do you mean, when you hiccup you feel more aware of your insides with a hiccup body shake? Oh, they absolutely hiccup in the womb. I'm 17 weeks with my first, so no personal experience, but my sister-in-law had the hiccupiest baby in there a few years ago, and the last month or two, her whole abdomen would jump. The sickest joke of all, you stop being able to sleep way before the baby gets here. Everyone loves to tell me to sleep now while I can, but pregnancy leads to unexplained insomnia, and I'm a total wreck already. Parents, before you get pregnancy, it's wonderful you have to do it. Parents 10 seconds after hearing you're expecting. Ahahahahaha, welcome to hell. No sleep for you. Prepare to age decades every month. I wish someone had told me that no, your body does not magically go back to normal once the baby is out. You have weeks of healing. Either your ripped vajayjay or cut open stomach. Your books are still on baby mode and have a whole new set of problems now. Pooping will be terrifying, lol. Depression risks are higher. Just a lot of stuff continues on after the baby. I don't know why people insist on visiting right after delivery. I'm tired, I'm busy with this baby, I'm tore up from the floor up. Please come in a month, when I can at least have some sort of a routine. The stuff that stays with your body afterwards. I developed allergies after I had my second. My feet definitely got bigger. Hormones are no joke. My feet grew half a size and my hair got curly. It was wavy before, but now I get ringlets. It also made my fingernails stronger. Also, I developed an aversion to beef that never really went away. I only eat it like once a month to this day, and my youngest is about to turn 10. It's like a second puberty. What the duck is happening to my body? I went partially blind in one eye. Apparently temporary blindness can happen in pregnancy, but my eyesight never returned. During labor, the water breaking is not one rush of liquid. It's continuous and can occur for several hours. It's horrendous and messy and incredibly awful to deal with. It feels like peeing, but you have zero control over anything, and if you tense up then everything is much more painful and weird feeling. Nobody ever told me that, and I was very surprised to find out for myself. I had adult diapers given to me by my sister-in-law. She had some unused ones left from her pregnancies. They are incredibly useful for if your water breaks and after you give birth and there is blood, so much blood. No one ever told me about the third delivery aka your first poop. I was struggling for so long. Second time around I started stool softener 2 weeks before my due date. Game changer. It was still scary but much easier. My older sister advised that I eat a couple of prunes every day for the last few weeks, and that I bring some to eat in the hospital as well post-delivery. Hands down, one of the best pieces of pregnancy advice I received. No one told me about the second one. I knew what the placenta was, but I thought it would just slosh out with a baby. When they told me to keep pushing after the baby was born, I was legit outraged. My ducking books hurt so bad. I hit one in my sleep and woke up in excruciating pain. Like, WTF. I knew they got bigger, but the pain was a surprise. I was told by my sister about books hurting in the first trimester from growth. She forgot to mention my nipples would feel like they were burning in hell. I also had this burning pain. Lanolin helped. Hang in there, it gets better. How tired you can be in the first trimester. I was falling asleep at my desk most days. I always hear that labor pains were like really awful period cramps. Nope. Mine felt like someone was stabbing the front of my hip. And, I had heard about sciatic pain, but was 100% unprepared for how bad it could be. I had a C-section and the gas pain was no joke. Had to sleep on an incline for days. My wife is in her first trimester, and she's exhausted. Sleeping 12 hours a night and often naps during the day too. It's crazy to me. She didn't expect it at all, and it's really frustrating her. Your hormones are crazy, literally making anything and everything that happens to your body a pregnancy symptom. Bloody nose, pregnancy. Hands dry, pregnancy. Itchy skin, pregnancy. Pregnancy is the wild ducking west, y'all. I found this so frustrating. I like to know why something is happening. Pregnancy is not an answer. Like, by what mechanism am I having random dizzy spells? What specific hormone is making sleep impossible? You would think these things would be studied like crazy because women have been having babies forever, but nope. Basically nothing. Medical studies have historically ignored women entirely for every condition because hormones too complicated. So I don't find it surprising if we know relatively little about pregnancy. That morning sickness isn't in the morning. And that I would be puking the whole time, not just in the beginning. Or that morning sickness isn't just puking, it can also just be this awful hell of constant nausea. First pregnancy I puked about 4 times. This time morning sickness was just constant nausea without any relief for 4 weeks. Puking would have at least bought me some downtime. But still not as bad as the people who have it, or hyperemesis the whole pregnancy. Each pregnancy is different, even with the same person. I have 3 kids. The first pregnancy was very typical, and followed the normal timeline. Second pregnancy was awful. I was miserable and sick the entire time. Third pregnancy was easy peasy, and I finally understood why some women liked being pregnant. Not currently pregnant, but I wish someone had warned me about muscle cramps. I had to learn a new way to pop my ankles, because every night I would pop them, and get mats of Charlie horses in my legs, that my fiance had to massage out. Oh god, the Charlie horses. And you can't reach down to massage your legs, because you're too big to bend. That no matter how much you planned and wanted your baby, postpartum depression can happen to you, and it is very very real. It is not something you can control. Hormones are liars. Partners of new moms, please pay close attention. Get help. Do not try to tough it out. Get help. That everyone has an opinion on what you do whilst pregnant, and how you want to raise your child. That cravings aren't just food. I crave dirt, particularly beach sand. The smell of the beach was excruciating. I just wanted to shovel handfuls into my mouth. I never ate dirt or sand, and the craving went away when baby was born. A friend of a friend told me she craved freshly poured asphalt, so in a way I'm glad my craving was just dirt. My mom craved gasoline so badly she didn't trust herself to pump her own gas. This is called pica. If anyone reading this is experiencing it, tell your care team. It might be a sign of a vitamin deficiency. Can be a sign of anemia too. Have your blood levels checked. Not everyone falls in love instantly. I like mine, but didn't fall in love till after a year. Watched a friend go through this. I visited her couple times in the first 6 months after birth. I got the distinct feeling she had not bonded with her baby, but didn't bring it up. About a year later she told me she had been worried she wouldn't bond with him, because he was just a crying pooping feeding ball of blub. Now he is almost 3, and she is very very happy. How I'd get loads of random skin changes. Skin tags. So many skin tags. Moles growing into skin tags and dropping off, like WTF body. Sandpaper dry skin, which I still get from time to time. Just this one patch on the back of my right hand. My facial skin changing from T-zone oily to T-zone flaky, and never going back. My psoriasis on my scalp going away. This did come back, but not as bad. Hair. So you stop shedding hair whilst pregnant, and you get really thick lovely hair. A few weeks after birth you start to lose all that extra hair. Literally handfuls will come out in the shower and it's really freaky. Miscarriage is ridiculously common. I say this as someone currently carrying a dead baby waiting for the NHS to give me a surgical removal. I'm sorry for your loss. How hard it can be to get and stay pregnant. Everyone imagines it will happen easily and quickly, and, unfortunately, it's not the case for so many women. And for women who've dealt with infertility or loss, how much anxiety you'll have throughout the pregnancy.